Hey guys, welcome to Tiagen Academy. If you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe it. In this tutorial, we will learn how to make the circuit diagram in freezing software. Okay, so let's get started. So first we will see how to download it. Go to Chrome and type here freezing free download. Scroll down and click on this link. Okay, so click on download and you can see your start download, so click on it. Okay, so guys, I have already downloaded it, so I'm not going to download it. I will give you the link in description box, so if you need, you can download from there. Okay, in my case it's downloaded in downloads. Okay, so you can see here, this is my zip file. So we have to extract it. After the extraction, you will get like this. And here is our application, so click on it. It will take a second. Okay, so when you open the first time, you will get this type of interface. So I'll introduce you. There's some components. You can see here, when you click on it, you will get the specification of software. There's a four section: welcome, breadboard, schematic, PCB and code. So this is our welcome page. This is our breadboard board. This is our breadboard page. Here we will make the circuit diagram. When you make the circuit diagram, it will create automatic schematic diagram, and here it will create a PCB board. Okay, in this section you can write the Arduino code, you can compile from here and upload from here. Okay, so later on we will discuss it. First we will make the circuit diagram. Okay, so this is our breadboard. Oh guys, so there is some component like mine. Okay, so when we import the library from the other source, so it is visible in this section. There's a Arduino module, so you will get all the modules of Arduino here. There is some like SparkFun module, and there's a lot of things. Okay, so how we will import the library, we will also see. Okay, so currently we will interface the LCD with Arduino. Okay, so if you want to resize the breadboard, you can resize it. Like you can see here, there is a lot of options: half, half plus, full and full plus, mini, tiny. Okay, so currently I'm going to select half. If you want to rotate it, just click right click and rotate 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 90 degree counterclockwise. So I'm going to rotate 90 degrees. Okay, so hope you all are aware about the breadboard. These two sections are internally connected vertical, and this is also connected vertical, but these two sections are internally connected in horizontal. Okay, so we need Arduino Uno. Just click enter. Okay, so you can see here. Okay, I want to rotate it. So right click, 90 degrees. Okay. Well guys, so next we need LCD. Okay, and we need a potentiometer. and we need 1K resistor. Okay, so you can select and you can change the value from here. Right, we need 1 kilo ohm. Okay. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to provide VDD and ground. So like. Okay guys, so just click on it and drag it. Okay, we can change the color of wire. Like there's a lot of colors: blue, red, black, yellow, green, gray, white, orange. So we will change it a red color. Select the wire and take a point. You can drag anywhere. Now we are going to connect with ground. Okay, and we will change the color. So as we know, LCD pin diagram, like this is our VSS pin, VDD pin. So when you click on it, you will get the name of every pin. Okay, so this is our VSS pin and we have to connect with ground. Okay, so click on it and drag it. Okay, so we will change the color as a black. This is our VDD pin, so we have to connect with 5 volt and the red, our V0 pin. This is our V0 pin, it's a contrast pin, so we will connect with potentiometer. Okay, we will change the color yellow. Okay, so we have to connect this pin to potentiometer as a 5 volt. Okay, let's change the color red. This is our ground. Okay, so change the color. Okay, guys, this is our RS pin. We will connect it on pin number 12. This is our pin number 12. Okay, so change the color as a blue. Okay, and this is our red and white pin. Okay, so we have to connect with ground. Black color, enable pin. So we will connect with it on pin number 11. So change the color blue. D0. Okay, so we know there is a 8 data pins in LCD, so we will use only 4 data, like D4, D5, D6 and D7. and there is something like cathode pins, and this is our anode pin. Okay, so D7 pin, we will connect D7 pin on pin number 2. D6, it will connect on pin number 3. D5, we will connect on pin number 4. It's a D4, it will connect on pin number 5. Okay, so this is the anode pin. We will connect with 5 volt. Okay, and this is our cathode pin. So we will use the 100 kilo ohm resistors. We will rotate it 90 degree. Change the color red. So guys, you can see here, this is our full circuit diagram, LCD interface with Arduino. Okay, so you can see here in schematic, it will generate automatic schematic diagram and PCB diagram. So you can arrange it, like rotate it as you want, and this is our code section. So we can write the code here. And we can upload the code in Arduino from here or compile the code. Okay, so first of all, we have to link the bridging software with Arduino. So how to link it? Let's see. Go in edit, preference. There's one more option, code view. And you can see here, this is our location. We have to set the location. Just click on 3 dots. Go to your Arduino section where it installed. Like in my case, I am installing C drive, program file, Arduino. Okay, so you can see here, like Arduino debug. We have to select Arduino debug, this one, and open it. Okay, and just click on OK. Okay, so let's see. We will. Okay, so you can see here, this is my code, and here we will select the which one board you are using, like Arduino or other boards, and you will select which one board you are using, like Arduino Uno, Nano, Mega, everything is here. Okay, so currently it's not showing the board ports. So now I'm going to connect Arduino USB. So you can see here, I have connected on port number 3. Okay, so we can upload from here on clicking this button. Okay, hope you guys understand. If you have any doubt, please tell me in comment section. Okay, so now we will see how to import the library. Let's suppose first we have to download it. Right now I'm going to download 7 segment. Segment bridging library. Okay, so you can see here, we can download from here. Okay, now let's see how to add it in bridging. Okay, so guys, you can see here, there is a 4 lines, just click on it, click on import. In my case, I have downloaded in downloads. So you can see here, Adafruit 0.56 inch 7 segment, select. select it, open it, you can save. Library has added in pleasing software. Okay, so keep one thing in your mind, like you have to download properties. Extension will be always FZ PZ. It will work, otherwise it will not work. So remember this point. Hope you guys understand. If you have any doubt, tell me in comment section. Sure, I will reply you guys. Please like the video and subscribe the channel and share with your friends. Thank you so much.